Or if you're something to go on like that. There's absolutely something wrong. If you always have this negative view of life, this continuous discontentment, will form you, will never improve. If you're always discontenting your life, you're thinking negatively, you want to have it, you follow it, you go with you. I remember from my own personal experience, I started a household chore. And for some reason or the other, I was not able to finish it. I said, oh, let me leave this, maybe something I'm always forgetting about it. I'm too to finish this job. And if you're not able to just release yourself, you start some project, and for some reason you're not able to finish it. So I went and I did something else. And I had this negative feeling that this one that I started also, this one too. I don't want to be old. You know, I was not even to finish. But I went under something else, and it just keep repeating itself, because what's happening, that I have that negative attitude about this whole day. I had it embedded in my head. You know what? This day is not going to be old. So you want to be old. That's how it turned out. So you have to develop. You know, right? You have to develop a very positive attitude. And with that positive attitude, what will happen is that you will become very successful. And with that positive attitude, you are contented that one that you fill with success and happiness and all the good things that you expect of that. And within my meeting of the 3 month I want Mahadeo after, right? It comes from book 10. And tonight I want to talk strictly about the meaning of the power of Krishna. And we did. And as you join with me, as we chant these preludes to the Sanskrit text from the Srimad Bhagavatam. Pleasure in going out to the steel. sisters and the group. What he did, he didn't know how to become a spirit. He took a rope and tied it around his waist. And he had a stick. And he waved it. And the cow started dragging all over the place. So my sister, you know what, shaking her head. And this he did naturally. He didn't know the story of the Mahabharata and of Krishna's Leela, but he did that. Something that comes in a child naturally. In order to, and sometimes when our children are doing things, you know, we stop them. We say, don't do this, don't do that. Don't put your hand in it, it's hard. You know, by experimenting with nature, experimenting with the things around the house, this child gains intelligence. But I want to tell you, my father, he didn't gain much intelligence by that man. And this is no joke. And he complained about his back from that young age, complained of his back until he was there. He says, if you probably correct the name of the college brought. If you crowd it around like that, I would think it would be very healthy to the one of God and the other was different. Then, if I can continue and tell us about the Lord Krishna, the gopis, the ladies who lived in that village, they held the Hathari in the Gaur province. He would want to do it with the woman, steal the economics, comments, you'll drink as much as you want. And he and his friends, he came to our friends, as he was going over, he had one of your money friends. You drink the tahi, and then when he's finished, when he can't drink anymore, he drink his heart's content. And what he would do next, he would great problems. The great men. Why was he making the problems? Here we have a classic case of contentment being shown. We as adults, we teach our children, we say, you must be content, you must share. I remember my brother and his wife. You know this thing. So I pick one big sour cup and I put sugar inside. Mix it up good. I went to the room and I said, this is our cookie. Sour cup with sugar. It goes really good, right? And you already know that. And he came with half a new tour. He says, don't tell me what you tell me yourself. I had to do it. You know, as children, we're told, you gotta be content, you gotta share. Right? But look at the adults. The adults. This is what can be drawn from this little story about Krishna. Look at the adults. They won't get the one more. They won't get the one more. And we're telling our children, we are gathering things, all sorts of things for ourselves. We are telling our children, as we are gathering things, we're telling our children we must be content, and we are not content. But Krishna is telling us, look, you're going to keep this all for your family? He's telling the gopis, you're going to keep this all for your family? No, the animals are dying. He also removes the cows. Roosted so that they could suckle on it and the rest of the mothers. He's telling them, this is not all the humanity, this is for the whole world.
Thank you. Thank you.
servitor to us. That same is going to be there. When he was alive here, he lived from 1977 to 2004 in New York City. And every year, he would gather at his home. He loved the city, he loved family. He would gather at his home and would go into the celebration. This celebration tonight was freaky for him. Whether, she had no choice whatsoever but to join in. They did a great job. My mother and my father came from New Jersey. All of those who know him, know him, but attested to this night that he did. Thank you. Jyoti Satsangh. We have commercial free television from 12 noon to 1 p.m. and we'd like to thank all of you for watching us here. Until we soon be on, we will have something right here once again. And do come out to all the announcements we make. Really, please support all of them. And Pandit, I know you have a lot of people to thank because this was a big Yagna, a beautiful Yagna. And please go ahead.
First and foremost, Dr. Dhanpaul, I want to thank you for hearing this lesson, this lesson, this flyer for the months of the week after week for the past 6 weeks or so, because it has caused the audience to know and to show up for this lesson. And that's a great thing. So I want to thank God for allowing me and giving it my family this prayer so that we were able to accomplish this lesson as we know in Yagna. Is not something simple,
yes.
It involves a lot of preparation.
Plan, yeah.
And I want to thank my family because they all contributed a whole lot. I want to thank the Rishiram for being a splendid Pooja and for doing the greatest of invitations to the gods and the goddesses, because that too is the whole part of our Poojas and our Yajnas or weddings, whatever the culture may be. I want to thank with all the singers who were prepared as you all have seen a great job in making this Yagna success at all times, especially the harmonium prayer that people really sing. And then the girl prayer that he sings all the time. A little for shoulders slide to
do this. He's a tech person, he's very good.
The technical assistance really did a great job in getting the audience involved. I want to thank the New York City Sanatan Mandir. By the way, this is the place where I go at least once a month and do service for the public. We want to come look after the district of the 2375 89 Street to the East Campus, New York. And once again, I thank you and your reception.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Yes, so Rakeshji, thank you, sir. He's a star. He's a star too. Yes. So thank you very much. I'd like to thank so many of you, millions of you, for watching.
If I forgot to thank everyone, please
thank you. Millions of you are watching us this morning. Thank you very much. And you know, the Satsang comes in the comfort of the living rooms. And we bring you week after week commercial free television here promoting Hindu culture, authentic Hindu culture. And in case you don't know, Pandit is a very brilliant scholar. He had 10 subjects in a GCE O level, a bachelor's degree and a master's degree in the United States in psychology. So Pandit, you take us religion very, very far. And we're proud of you and we're proud of your family as well. And we want to thank you for being in studio this morning.